fair had everything. When you tired of the auto racing, you could always watch the camels run. That is, if you weren't chasing after the penny toss car or gawking at the movie stars and celebrities. Fatty Arbuckle and Mabel Normand, for instance. Or listening to John Philip Sousa lead the band in the Court of the Universe. There were daredevils to amaze you. Some were in the water and others in the air. There was plenty of culture and history, too. Beautiful girls and beautiful animals. It was the most wonderful thing that ever happened to San Francisco.
Welcome, it's Shows at Infinity here. What I'm going to present is the Panama Pacific International Exposition held in San Francisco in the year 1915. So these photos were captured over 100 years ago, and every photo has history to it. It's just kind of strange to me looking back at these photos, knowing that most of this doesn't exist anymore. And it just feels weird to me seeing how people were back in those days. This World's Fair and others around the world throughout the past always seem fun and wonderful and something that I would have definitely have gone to if given the chance. But I just can't help feel a slight eeriness to this all. Like something isn't right. I'm just so perplexed at how advanced these people were and how they managed to do all of this in the timeline. Not to even mention that they demolished most of the fair after it had finished, even though they were in good condition. It's strange seeing so many things come together. Religion, culture, traditions, people sharing different technologies. The fair was opened on the 20th of February and closed on the 4th of December 1915. One more thing that I want to say that I found interesting about this collection is the supposed construction photos, and you will see these scattered throughout the collection. The reason I find this interesting is because looking at these images and looking at the architecture and everything that went into this, it's very hard to see that they did all of this within a couple of years. So I just want you guys to question whether these construction photos are actually of construction. It might have been the demolition part, and these photos were just repurposed as the construction. That's just something I want you to keep in mind. Without further ado, make sure you sit back and enjoy this. Thank you.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
The fair closed officially on December 4th of 1915. Closing ceremonies were filled with emotion, and nearly 500,000 people wept as the flag was lowered from the Tower of Jewels. The scintillator, manned by Marines, projected patterns of light on great clouds of steam thrown into the air from a locomotive painted to look like marble. Everyone stayed to watch the lights, wandering quietly in the gardens, looking for the last time. As the lights went out, something left our youth. But the fair has endured. The beautiful Palace of Fine Arts still stands there. Gently crumbling, but gently reminding, the exposition has lived on. In the hearts and memories of every man, woman, and child that spent an enchanted summer at the City of Jewels.